Happy New Year and New Month. Hello and welcome back. I'm Willow Grace. Thank you for joining me as we take a look ahead at your astrology forecast for the month of January. Now, before we begin to start talking about astrology, if you're interested in working with me, you can visit my webpage to schedule a tarot and astrology consultation. You can also learn and participate by signing up for one of my classes. If you would like to receive your monthly astrology update by email, this information can be found at willowgracemystic.com, or you can look in the link below. If you're interested in a gift certificate, please, you can contact me at willowgrace143@gmail.com. Thank you for listening and watching this video. If you'd like to receive your updates when they first come out, please hit the like button and subscribe to the channel below. Now let's dive in. Taurus, we are out of the heat of this eclipse season of the November, December, where we had major shifts, major endings, major beginnings, and now we are in the flow of whatever was started will now pick up speed and we will just flow with it. So this is about easing our anxiety, moving forward with a new purpose and a new direction. We're going to start off the month with the sun. It's illuminating your ninth house. So the ninth house represents travel, foreign people, foreign things. This is religion, philosophy. This will be part of the theme of, or a major theme of, your month ahead. Strong energy for the month will include Sagittarius, Capricorn, and Aquarius. So Sagittarius for you, this is immigration, international business, travel, different cultures, teaching, learning. All of these things will be at the forefront for you. Capricorn issues or topics, that would be employment, career, life purpose, father figures, boss. All of these will be at the forefront. And the last is Aquarius. The Aquarius energies bring a focus on the whole and the greater good, connecting with others, mutual goals, mutual friendships, technology and innovative solutions and ideas and quick thoughts. Remember, it is electric and ideas. So before we begin, I want to backtrack a little bit and talk about December 19th. On December 19th through January 29th, Venus is stationed retrograde. I talked about this in my December forecast. And so with this, Venus is in your house of the foreign people, foreign things, and international travel, and technology and learning. And so Venus, she rules money, love, beauty, self-esteem topics from the past. These things will be creeping back in. And so this is you having to avoid major decisions that are not easily changeable. This could be a change of plans of somewhere that you wanted to go. This is about you having to be flexible on the things that you love and things that you value and things that, and it's traveling, foreign people, foreign things, and higher education. This is a good time for you to have low budget fixes for these things, things that can be easily changed or adjusted in this area of your life. Next, we have January 2nd. We're going to have a new moon at 12 degrees of Capricorn. Remember, the Capricorn part of your chart in your ninth house is at the forefront for the majority of the month. So this is a time to set intentions. New moons mean new beginnings, fresh starts, clean slates, and these need to be in line with the qualities of Capricorn. So think slow and steady. Think things that you can develop, things that can be maintained or sustained over time. So a goal which has sub-goals to get you where you want to go. Things that will benefit multiple people. This for you in this house of maybe career with not just career, but like learning for your career or teaching with your career or something that has to do with writing for your career. This is travel. And all of this is going to be illuminated with this new moon. Then on January 14th, Mercury retrograde will actually start. The shadow period started December 29th. I added that into my December YouTube video, if you want to go back and listen to that. Now, when Mercury is in its retrograde cycle, all types of communication and travel, they become susceptible to disruption. It's not a time to start new things, but it's time to go back and finish them. So you've started something in this house with this new moon. And now Mercury is going to say, now let's go back and fine tune and tweak these areas so it is sustainable over the long period, over the long haul. This is about planning, research, slow and steady development, going back and fine tuning and tweaking, looking over paperwork with a fine tooth comb. Then next on January 17th, we're going to have a full moon at 27 degrees in the sign of Cancer. Now, this is illuminating, everybody's going to feel it, but it's going to be illuminating your third house of communication, siblings, neighbors. Now, the day is going to be supercharged with feelings. Remember that Cancer is ruled by the moon, and the moon rules our house, our home, our family, our foundation, our roots, and past, our past lives, or our foundation. And so this things will be illuminated that we didn't know about. Water will come to the forefront. This is about not expecting people to feel a certain way just because we do or you do. This is allowing them to, it's about intense energy. Full moons reveal and illuminate things that were hidden. So there may be some thoughts or ideas or feelings that may come to the forefront that we just didn't know about or didn't expect. Then the last is on January 19th. The sun is going to shift from the sign of Capricorn into Aquarius. It is now going to illuminate your 10th house of career. So you're going to take all this knowledge that you're gaining and learning and bringing in other people, and you're going to be bringing your career to focus, to the forefront. This is your public life, your life goals, your work, it's the midheaven, the middle of heaven, where the sun shines on your chart of what is illuminated, of where you're supposed to be going. So this will bring the focus to this house, and this will take you into February. Thank you for listening and watching this video. If you would like to receive updates as soon as they come out, please hit the like and the subscribe button to the channel below. And make sure you share with your friends who you think might be interested in this information. You can also find me on Facebook, where I do live offerings for personal updates. And you can sign up for my newsletter at willowgracemystic.com, or you can click the link below. I would love to hear your thoughts on how this energy is manifesting in your life in the comments below.